Farmington. It's your boy Nehemiah Rocket.
And Jenna Lipham.
Thank you for joining us for this week's edition of Focus on This. Yeah. So how was your spring break, Jenna?
My spring break was good. You know, I didn't do a whole lot. I slept and I worked, but we hit up that lamp in Bora Bora.
Solid 2 hours. I recommend everybody go there. Bora Bora.
It was a good
awesome
time.
Awesome place. You know, we got about half the school's population, you know, at Minnesota Conference. So they're away
everyone's
doing
everyone's there today. I mean, congrats on making it, but you're going to miss out on an awesome show.
Awesome show. We got great stuff planned.
Speaking of that, Nick is missing. Currently.
Yeah, where is Nick? He's just gone. Wait,
let's hope he's at the Minnesota Conference.
Yeah,
but other
hopefully.
Than that, what do we got today?
So this week we just have Devin for listening up. Let's see what he has in store.
Hey, Farmington. Put those pencils down. Turn off Justin Bieber for this time to listen up. You guys heard about Kevin Ware, the Louisville basketball player? He just recently broke his leg in a pretty horrific way. It looked like a lunchroom breadstick just snapping right in half. Now, while we can't actually show you the video, it is pretty gruesome. Just hold on just a second. If you can imagine, this is his bone. And this is his leg. It looked a little something like that. Like I said, it was just horrible. But don't worry. Even though it was one of the most disgusting things I've ever seen in my life, his doctor, Dr. Glashow, immediately underwent a 2-hour surgery on his leg. And it looks like he's going to be recovering pretty quickly. He spoke to HollywoodLife.com and stated that he's thinking it's going to be about 6 months. That's all it's going to take for him to recover, and he'll be back on the court within that time, too, which is pretty amazing because it looks gruesome. Another news. A biker bunny got pulled over on Saturday. You heard me right, a biker bunny. A man dressed in a full Easter bunny costume was driving a motorcycle with a passenger sidecar on the freeway. He said he was going to an event where it was required to be dressed up. The officer pulled him over and told him that the headpiece obstructed view of other motorists. And I can just imagine driving and seeing a bunny driving a motorcycle. It must have been worth it. I don't know. I would do it. I would do it. But I've just wondered throughout all these years at Farmington High School how Mr. Cush has gotten so tall. But I recently found out how he got so tall. Researchers have discovered that education makes you shrink less in old age. That's right. Shrinks less in old age. If you've completed secondary school, you will shrink nearly 2 centimeters less than those that are illiterate. The team from the universities of Southern California and Harvard say it's the first time it's been shown that education or that choices later in life can affect your height rather than in childhood. If you live in the suburbs, it's shown that you will shrink much less, actually about 0.9 centimeters less. If you go on and complete high school, it looks like you're about 1 centimeter less. And if you continue further on and just keep learning, you can shrink even less, about 0.3, they say, if you do college. That's all I got for news, but it looks like finally winter is coming to an end, and I think I can speak for all of us. I'm just ready for summer. I'm ready. The warm weather's getting me excited to do so many different things, go tubing, jump rope, play chalk. I can't wait to get crazy with all my friends graduating here. Hey, that's all I got for listening up. Now back to Jen and Nehemiah back in the studio.
Thanks for that, Devin.
Awesome.
Hopefully we'll see Nick next week, but you did awesome today by yourself. And we have Shakira here with some yearbook information. What do you got for us?
All right. Well, this is our yearbook for the upcoming year. This is the front and the back. Okay. And we're selling them during all lunches at the tables next to concessions. So that's what we're doing there. And yearbooks are $75 each if you buy it through the school. But if you go to Jocelyn's to buy it, you have to pay more money. And we're only selling them this week and next week during all lunches. And we only have 250 yearbooks left. So come and get your yearbook now before they're all gone. And if you're not sure if you bought a yearbook, we can just look it up for you.
Sweet.
All right, thank
you. Sounds awesome. Thank you for that.
So be sure to get your yearbook, guys. And hopefully if your yearbook picture is bad and you had some acne, Dr. Oz knows how to fix that up. So let's check it out.
Talk about the most, you know, hated thing that all high schoolers hate. It's acne. You know, this skin condition that causes pimples and zits has probably visited you at some point in your life. And it's probably at the most inopportune time, like when you are, you know, going on a date, you're about to go to a movie, and there's just bam, pimple right on your nose. You look like Rudolph, and it sucks. It stinks, you know? Hate it. So many people think that it's because of greasy foods or all the chocolate that you're eating, but that's not the reason. Unless you're taking that French fry and putting it in your face, rubbing it around, that's not the reason that you have, you know, acne all up on your face. Another common myth is that acne is caused by dirt. Dirt does not cause acne. Unless you go take a mud bath and you're gonna sit in that for about a week, it does not cause acne. So acne is actually caused by all of the oil. When it's excess, it creates bacteria in your pores, fills them up, and then you get those blemishes like whiteheads or blackheads. Now that you know what acne is, I'm gonna tell you how to treat it. First, there's topical medications. Like, you got your skin lotion, you got your face wash, you know. Anything that has benzoyl peroxide 10 is gonna be the best for you. So if you use that, it'll probably take it away within a day or two. If your skin is like really delicate, you're gonna wanna use a low chemical face wash. Another thing you do is take pills. Pills are prescribed by the doctor. They're an antibiotic to get rid of the bacteria that causes the acne, but those will come with side effects depending on what it is, but you have to read the labels. Other things you can do at home, you can wash your face, easy. Take a shower, wash your face, you're all clean. You should also avoid greasy cosmetics. That's mostly for the girls. Don't leave your makeup on overnight or you could have an acne breakout. You should also wash your pillowcase. That's the most important part. If you don't wash your pillowcase, you're gonna go to bed, you're gonna get all the grease on your pillowcase, wake up in the morning, you know, do all your stuff, then when you go back to bed, you're gonna have more grease on your face just because you didn't wash your pillowcase. That's not good. You're gonna get a lot of acne. So now, a lot of you use Proactive. The thing about Proactive is it is going to cause you to break out for about a month, which that's not cool, you know, but it will get rid of all your acne after that. It may take less for a month than if you have different skin types, it varies. So what it does is it's gonna take all of the pores, it's gonna clean them, which brings up the acne, like you get some white heads, and then it'll clean it off when you use the other two steps of the Proactive. So that's all I have for today. Make sure you wash your face, clean your pillowcase, and stay healthy. Tune in next week, I'm gonna be talking about tanning. Back to you guys.
Thank you for those tips. Sounds really good.
Yeah, hopefully we'll be seeing some cleaner faces here around Farmington.
Face wash every night. All right, well, that's all we have for you right now. Let's send it to break and we'll be right back.
Attention teens everywhere. We know it's a hard time for you right now. You don't know if your crush likes you back, you got homework, and guess what that causes? Stress, and stress causes acne. No one wants to see that. It's disgusting, all right? So we're gonna fix it for you with Go Active. We got three easy steps. Let's check it out.
Step one, put about a handful of the renewing cleanser in the palm of your hand to get started. Step two, wipe down your face with the toner solution. Step three, lather on the repairing treatment and you're set. Be sure to rinse your face thoroughly after using the product so that it stays nice and moist. After rinsing your face thoroughly, be sure to add the moisturizer to help keep the product rid of your face so it's not oily and shiny.
Before Go Active, I had really bad acne. I was always in the background popping my zits. Nobody ever noticed my great personality behind my hideous face covered with zits. I would always hide when a picture was being taken, but that's all in the past. Now that I started using Go Active, my face is clean, clear, and under control.
Walking down the hallways was a tragic experience for me. People would always scream and run at the sight of my face that was covered with big red zits. The day I ordered Go Active was the best day of my life. Before it even came in the mail, I noticed my acne had already started to go away.
Order the new Go Active today for just 8 payments of $49.99. That's right, just 8 payments of $49.99. Call the Zit Hotline now at 1-800-KILL-A-ZIT. That's 1-800-KILL-A-Z-I-T.
I haven't had a girlfriend since third grade, and I really hope this Go Active helps.
Side effects may include acne, less friends, interaction with peers, being ignored, zit explosions, redness, itching, burning, and peeling.
Well, welcome back, FHS. So as you know, we have Games for Change coming up here pretty soon.
Did you get your team together?
I did today. Today I brought in my money, I brought in my forms. Make sure your signature is your parents and not your own. But yeah, I got my own team together. It's going to be me, Joey, Dawson, and Wyatt. And then we have Hannah, Summer, Claire, and Catherine. And
the volleyball players.
Exactly. So I have a pretty mean spike. You know, I plan on destroying in that game.
All right. Well, I hope you guys win. So we got a little bit to show you more about that because we still don't know what it is. There's still time to sign up, and we want to take a peek at what we did last year.
Hi, I'm Dan Bunsey, here with Miranda Larson. We're going to talk about Games for Change. So, I'm pretty new to this. What can we expect?
Well, with Games for Change, it's a lock-in to raise money for the food shelf at Farmington, and we will be playing dodgeball, floor hockey, capture the flag, and volleyball. It's super fun, and there's always a lot of teams, and we raise a lot of non-perishable food items as well.
That's pretty cool. So, who exactly is the charity?
The charity is for youth development. We are collecting money and non-perishable food items for the Farmington food shelf, and this year we are also going to be making sandwiches for the food shelf, as well as collecting new or hardly used shoes for Souls for Souls. And we'll be sending those to Iowa so they can be sent to third world countries such as Haiti.
Okay. Oh, and also, when can I sign up and where?
You can sign up every day this week at lunch. Just make sure that you bring in your money with your envelope, you have an appropriate team name, you get a parent signature with your permission slip, and we do not accept forged signatures, so we are looking for that.
No forged signatures.
This is my first year doing Games for Change. Not only am I excited to play some sports, but I'm really excited to help people too. You should try it.
All right, thanks for that, Dan. So we have Sydney Bachelman here. It's going to be an awesome. I'm not doing it this year, but Nehemiah is, and she's going to tell you what you need to do.
All right, as Miranda said, Games for Change is coming up, and this year we've added the Souls for Souls component. So Souls for Souls is a corporation that collects shoes for individuals worldwide who are in need of shoes, either from a natural disaster or don't have the money to buy shoes. The FHS goal is to collect 500 pairs of shoes by April 19th. That's only 2 weeks away, so please bring in your shoes. There are 4 spots within FHS to drop the shoes off, one by each office, and then the other entrance that's by the student parking lot. Also, in the community, you can bring the shoes to Round Bank, Synergy Dance Center, Anytime Fitness, Market on Oak, City Hall, Count Interrupted Ice Cream, Trinity Terrace, Farmington Community Education, and FHS once again. Please make sure you guys all bring in your shoes because we would really like your help. And this is a way to involve the whole school in Games for Change.
Oh, that sounds awesome.
I want to contribute.
Thanks, Mr. Mathis.
You know, I don't have any shoes to give, but my mom's saying she wants to clean out the pantry. So, you know, I'll be bringing in lots of food. I'm gunning for that McDonald's, so watch out.
All right, even though I'm not participating, I'm going to bring in a lot of shoes because I love shoes, but my mom told me I have to get rid of a bunch. So I'm kind of sad, but it's good to help out others. So thanks for that,
for
Sydney.
A good cause. Yep.
And so now, for those of you that don't know who Mo Cash is, we did a little feature on him to see who he is and introduce you to that character because he's pretty popular in our studio. Let's check it out.
Hey, yo, my name is Mo Cash. I'm 29 years old. From southern Minneapolis, actually. Not a whole lot of people know that about me. Grew up from ages 3 to 18. I was just constantly outside on the streets in Minneapolis. Went from, you know, crew to crew, running with. I know pretty much everybody in Minneapolis, actually. You can ask them. Just ask them about Mo Cash. They'll be like, yeah, I know that guy. Actually, for a long time, my passion was the kazoo. Not a whole lot of people know that. I started my first band when I was 12. It was a three-piece called Three Kazoo Pileup. But after a couple years, the band split up and my kazoo broke. And so I took a break from that to focus on my real new passion of rapping. You know, I just like to get in the booth, straight kick out a couple verses, you know, maybe 10, 15 every 3 hours. You know, I like to spend a lot of time in the beat factory, if you know what I mean. Well, for focus on this, my actual title is Director of Moonbase Operations, but I like to think of myself as more of a visionary. I envision things, if you know what I'm saying. I envision the green screen in the studio, actually, so I mean, I'm the mastermind behind that. This entire idea, in fact, was actually my idea. It was initially called Focus on That, and it was kind of me going around pointing at things, but we decided that we kind of wanted to flesh it out, get some other components going, and you know, I recruited, handpicked the rest of the crew, and that's where we are. Yeah, before I go, I'd like to make a couple shout outs, if that's okay. Shouts out to Goots Bailey. Shouts out to Mad Dog Slim. Shouts out to Mad Dog. Shouts out to Mad Puppies. Shouts out to Shout Detergent. And shouts out to North Dakota. Word up. This interview's done, man.
All right, well, thanks for hand-picking me to be on the show.
Yes, I feel very special. Well, thank you for joining us this week. You know, it's been very interesting. You know, we had a lot of fun filming stuff.
Thanks for tuning in for our first official show, and I hope you guys had as much fun as we did. But be here next week because it's going to be just as great.
Awesome stuff planned, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yep, so I'm Jenna.
I'm Nehemiah Rocket.
And we're going to leave you with the choir singing at Animal Kingdom and their tour in Florida over spring break.
Have a great weekend.
Yatsu yatsu liyer minaguni yatsu yatsu amina baba yatsu yatsu liyer jina la koeli tsukuse. Baba yet to the end, Binguni yet to Amina Baba.